see this right here. You see these tricks. You think they're impressive. You think they're all that. But I'm here to tell you that right here, right now, this is amateur hour at the Apollo. This is nothing compared to what I can do.
Skater Hater.
Could you tell us who you are?
You serious, bruh?
Yeah.
Oh, you're serious?
Yeah.
Oh, he doesn't know who I am.
They don't know who you are. You're trying to introduce to them.
Oh, trust me, they know. I think you don't.
Okay.
I'm the next Tony Hawk. I'm the next Rob Dyrdek.
I'm
a wild grinder, bro.
What's your name?
Whatever, dog. My name's Jeff, and I'm the best skater you'll ever meet in your life, bro.
How much does skateboarding mean to Jeff, and what do you know about his journey?
Skateboarding Jeff? His journey? How much does skateboarding mean to Jeff? Nothing. He literally watched one episode of Zeke and Luther and thought he was a part of the crew. It means everything. Not just to him, but to me.
So you're saying he's a fraud?
Exactly what I'm saying, bro. He's just annoying.
And incompetent.
Just overwhelmingly stupid!
Oh my god.
Exactly.
I'm so happy.
Me and him, we've been like this. Me and him, we've been day one. Hell, he even got me my first Fortnite dub.
But you have to see. What? We caught him. You have to see what we have here.
Look, see what? See what?
No,
let me
watch.
See.
Just watch.
What is it?
You gotta wait a little bit.
He's not just rad. He's epic. He's radical. He's the most epic skater I've ever known.
Okay, I'll see it. No way.
I hate this guy. No way.
Have you ever seen him skate before?
I don't need to, man. Man, don't be such a splunk.
What do you say to the people who are calling you a fraud, saying can't ride a skateboard, let alone do a trick?
Dude. Are you busting my balls right now, bro? Like,
no.
Dude, you can't be cramping my style like that, man.
Listen, it's just a question.
Nah, dude, you're acting like a total super splunker right now, bro. I'm gonna need you to take it from a 10 to a 2. Where things get wicked
okay.
in here.
Okay. No need to get wicked. You know, we'll just
this
question
guy.
People
oh
want to know.
God.
I think you'll be happy to know. You know, we've been following you for a bit for the interview just to track your progress and stuff, you know, see how you are on the board. Just looking at all your tricks, you know?
Yeah?
Yeah, we're just gonna show the audience later.
No.
I mean, it's good, right?
No. I think that it should be a surprise. I don't want the audience to to get spoiled. I wanna do them good tomorrow.
Yeah.
I love my audience.
Yeah, I get that.
So it's been real, but I should probably go home.
Yep.
Get some rest for my big day tomorrow.
Oh well, rest. Don't you need a practice for tomorrow?
No. See, you just don't got the right mindset, dog. Ah, catch this. You need some sludge.
Excuse me?
Sludge. You don't know what sludge is?
No.
Ah, sludge is what drives me to be the best. Sludge, what comes out of my wheels after I grind on the crater. And you know what I say, I grind on a crater. If you're not down with that, then you're a skater hater. Anyways, I'm gonna get going, get my rest for my big day. See ya. Oh, wouldn't wanna be ya.
Just keep an eye on him.
I'll get in the car. I'll open the car.
You see him just running? No way.
Thank you.
I hate my job. I hate my job so much.
I don't need one.
Okay. Oh my god, thank god I had my helmet on. Oh my god, no, Haley, no, no! Haley!
You wanna go ride bikes?
Yeah, but remember,
don't forget your helmet!
Oh, I'm trying to watch off.
So it's the end of senior year. It's been a long 4 years, you know. It's COVID and all that. Doesn't even seem real. But I collected a couple of clips from my senior year. And, you know, people always say that they hate high school. They can't wait to grow up. They can't wait to get out of here. They can't wait to do things with their life. But I think it really starts in where you grow up. Everything's important. I think we shouldn't wait to live. I think you're living now. Might as well make the best of it. Don't. You're not really living if you're just waiting for something else the whole time. But you don't. It's a big moment, you know, leaving everything you've ever known. I don't understand how every year people go through these. I feel like we don't talk about how impactful, or not even impactful, terrifying it is to be told at the age of 17 or 18, you have to figure out what you want to do for the rest of your life. All your friends are doing this. All your friends are doing that. Everyone's asking what you're going to do, and they're going to want you to have an answer. So, but, you know, it's always worth remembering high school, I think. Some of the clips are not the right format because I ended up pulling stuff from, like, before this project. But most of them are. I think making this project, I included a whole bunch of clips. They're all from senior year of friends. It's all good memories. All good memories. All of them. And I think it's worth it to remember that I did live during high school. I didn't just wait, but I did live.
Came from you. question? No.
So,
yeah.
Hey man, I really like the hair.
Thanks.
Hey, yeah, you're welcome. Did you ever finish those math notes?
Oh, yeah, I can send them to you.
All right, thanks. Cool, man.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know that.
Do you have a Valentine's?
He should be. Yeah, you know, that's a little crazy.
Yeah, me too.
Mm-hmm.
Nice talking, I guess.
Yep.
Action.
Hey.
Oh, hey, so what's up?
Action.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Thanks, man, you too.
Do you have a Valentine's?
Nah, I'm like kind of.
Three, two, one, action.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Thanks, you too.
It's not a joke.
Do you have a Valentine's?
No. Nah, I'm actually like kind of busy after school today, so
I just want my mom. She's saying
yeah,
that
me too.
Guess I'll talk to you later. Though.
Yeah, no worries.
Action. Walk in.
Good. You? Oh, right. Happy Valentine's Day.
Yeah, you too.
Do you have any plans after school?
No, actually. Well, I have to get to my next class.
Oh yeah, I'll walk in. Okay.
Jeanne LaRue is known for her abstract and bold design choices, notorious for her astounding design featured in big magazines across the United States. She first started designing at the age of 12, having her first design featured on the cover of Vogue magazine.
And now we meet her bold competitor, Jean's very own brother, Ryan LaRue. Tell us, Ryan, when did you first start designing?
3 minutes ago.
Well, do you feel you can match the talents of your sister in tonight's competition?
No.
So, Miss LaRue, what would you say your inspiration for this dress would be?
The falsehood of royalty. The very serious nature of how deeply we believe in what we think is true, only to find out that cruel darkness will always be hidden behind the facade of royalty.
Mr. LaRue, since the crowd tonight has never seen you before, would you mind just telling us what your greatest piece of art is? What are you most proud of?
Oh, I know this one. This one right here. It's my greatest.
Oh. I meant a fashion piece.
Oh, you should have said so. The pepperoni pants, like, for sure.
So, Miss Jean, what would you say is the purpose of this piece is meant to be?
The world overlooks men's fashion. Well, of course a beautiful man could pull off the dress and heels look as well as a woman could. Fashion and masculinity should never be ignored.
That is beautiful. It's bad. No. It's good. This is chic. It's a modern, truly an inventive take on fashion as a whole. What is it?
Well, it's like this guy, right? And in this box. And I thought, what if the guy had a box on?
Magnificent!
Yeah! Uh-huh!
Mine was just nothing compared to anyone else.
So, what was your inspiration, Mr. Lehu?
Well, this guy, plastic bag.
I see, I see. Can he breathe in there?
No.
I see. He is just sleeping. We'll be back soon. It's cut there, you know.
What is this? No, no, don't say it. Please, just please don't.
I saw, like, you, you know? And I thought, what if he had a girl on his neck?
Oh, God.
You know? The drip, you know?
I hate you.
We'll be right back.